live with you once again. I had last week off, had a nice time with the visitor from Las Vegas. My name is Cathy Wilcox, just as it was before I left, and we have a very good show for you today. I want to do a little recap. Anyone who was with me 2 weeks ago when Matt Shantz was here, I was kind of jokingly asking him if he needed an announcer for his movie, and he and his dad were wonderful and said, yeah, we'd like you to announce. So I have the great honor and privilege of announcing the cast and the crew for Firefall. If you weren't there, it was an event. It was an absolute event at the Crest Theater. And I do have some pictures that I want to pull up. I'm not sure in which order. It doesn't really matter. But there's pictures of... There we go. Okay, this is a photograph of Gary Stotz. This is the dad of Matt in his full kilt regalia. And this is Matt, the director and writer. And this is my beautiful dress, which I have to give a shout out to a store, LBD, the little black dress, and it's located on Bullard. A number of the ladies got their dresses here, and it is a really incredible store. Carrie and her mom Jackie will take very good care of you when you go there. They have prom dresses, wedding, a formal attire, and my boyfriend Rick helped me pick this dress out, and it got a lot of compliments, and I was very happy to wear it. And I think there's one more picture. Is there another picture? There. Oh, that's, speaking of the devil, that's Rick. That's the man with the great taste on my arm on what I call the slip and slide. He calls it the step and repeat, but I call it the slip and slide because I can never remember step and repeat. So that's us. And was there one? There we go. And this is one of the, this is my dear, dear friend, Nancy O'Hara. She is a local actress. She's been in a number of different things. I met her years and years ago through Carolyn DeVore, who cast Firefall. And it was just a wonderful night. I re-met so many great people and met new people that I had only known on Facebook, who were my friends, and finally got a chance to meet them in person. It was just really fun. Outstanding movie. You have to see it. It's so funny. It was a packed house. And we have a message from a viewer, so let's see. Oh, and I rocked. Let me see, who could this be from? Thanks. Oh, is it from Matt? I can't think, Matt? That's so sweet. Well, thank you so much. And may I return the compliment. You rocked too, and you did. It was, and Heather, your wife, and I could just go on and on and on. It was just outstanding. It was so much fun, and deserve all the accolades that you received. And please keep us posted because we want to know, you know, when it's coming out on DVD and when all these things are going to be available for, hopefully around Christmas we can give these as presents, because really, you have to see this movie. It is so funny. I gave it a 10. I'll give it a 10 again. Okay. Next, we're going to move on to our animals, adoptee animals, before we move on to our first guest, who is a repeat guest, who was on my very first show, and she's wonderful. I want to bring up our little adorable pets for the week for adoption. And this is from Rosie Davenport at Valley Animal Center. And this, we have two doggies. Now, I had a husky, and huskies are wonderful. They are incredibly intelligent. They're brothers, Max and Matrix, and they're looking for a forever home together. So they want to be adopted together, and they are adorable. They're husky mixes, about a year old. They have a lot of energy. They do. They have a lot of energy, but they're very, very intelligent, and they like a challenge. They do like to be challenged, and they can learn tricks. They're wonderful, wonderful pets. And oh, so cute. And then we have our key cat. This is Jenna. She's a tabby, long hair. And you'll see this little one wandering the halls when her favorite volunteer isn't around. That's so cute. That she tends to keep to herself. She has been a part of our family for 3 years, and our family meaning the animal center. And she has a little trouble trusting humans. Understandable. But she is the perfect definition of what it means to be a shy cat. There's no paw swiping or hissing from. And Jenna could give my cat Ozzy lessons about that, because Ozzy hisses in my face and scratches me every morning and wakes me up and lets me know it's time to be fed. So the animal, the Valley Animal Center is open for adoption 7 days a week, 10 a.m. to 4:30. Every potential adopter is required to submit an adoption application to be considered for adoption. Once the application is approved, there's an $85 adoption fee for cats and $175 for dogs. And you can get more information from www.valleyanimal.org. So they're always looking for donations and volunteers, and anything you can do to help our animals find homes, forever homes, is greatly, greatly appreciated. One more shout out for my trainer friend, Paul Watson. He has boot camps Mondays and Thursdays at 7 p.m., Saturday mornings at 7 a.m. Really? 7 a.m. on Saturday? Paul, really? 9 weeks, three times a week, for $100, and that's only $3.75 per workout. Now, let me tell you. I did a personal training. Paul was a guest here, and he was gracious enough to give me a freebie lesson, and it was awesome. I was pouring sweat by the time I was done, and which is a good thing. No, I was very happy about that. The price will go up to $150, which is still a great deal. However, because if you are a Voice of the Valley listener and you contact Paul by Saturday, this Saturday, the price will stay at $100. So I encourage all of you. Paul is phenomenal trainer. He is patient. You need to be patient when you're training me. And he's good. He goes over nutrition and everything. So you get the whole ball of wax with Paul. So contact him on Facebook and get more information about his boot camp. All right. So we got all our announcements out of the way. I am ready to move forward with Carol Love, who is a love, and she's gorgeous. She is my friend. We were trying to figure out how we met in the first place. Did you ever remember?
No.
I didn't either. I don't know how we hooked up, but cosmic forces brought us together somehow.
That's right.
And we were you were on my very first show. So thank you very much. And she's back. Yes. And at the time, you had and still have this phenomenal costume collection and dress collection, in which I wore one of the dresses. And we want to talk about, you found a store, and it's going to be opening very, very soon, and you can go in and, is it rent or purchase?
It's purchase.
Purchase. Okay, so get us caught up. What have you been doing? How did you find this place? Tell us.
Okay, it's really, really interesting because you know how I was pushing, trying to do, you know, spending money, trying to push and make this happen, and it wasn't happening. So what was wrong was that I was not letting God do it. I was trying to do it myself. So anyway, I had to go to the gym on Blackstone, and across from me, I used to go to the Assistant League all the time to see what treasures they have.
Yes.
And this new store was open right next to it. And so I said, I'm going to go and check in there. I went in and I met Doug, who is the owner of the store, and they have two stores, one in the tower and one on Blackstone. So he was saying that they were going to have some vintage things. And I said, oh, I just happened to have.
Funny you should mention vintage.
Funny you should mention that. So I took my catalog, and he took it, and his wife looked at it, and he came back. He said, we really, at this point, can't afford to buy things. He says, but we have a room in the tower store that we can empty out and put all of these beautiful clothes in there. And vintage and stuff like that, and hats and shoes. It'll be everything when we get going.
It is everything.
Oh, everything. We have everything. But I'm just so thrilled because they're such a wonderful couple, and they're so hardworking, and they're very fair and honest about everything. And I just feel, oh my God. So thank you, God. I didn't do that. That just happened, you know. So then. I was at the mixer for the film mixer, and I was sitting at a table with Vince's wife, and there was another young lady sitting there. She turned out to be from Los Angeles. She was up visiting a friend and was just there for that one night. And I had a hard time finding the place, and something said, go there. You got to find the place. Got there, started talking to her, and she's a fashion photographer from Hollywood, Marta Elena, and she does covers for fashion magazines, like that. So I got to talking, and she was saying, you know, when she's not doing a job, she has her own group of people. She has her own photographers and makeup people and everything. She's got a fabulous, fabulous model. And she said while she was here, she happened to find an old hotel in Modesto, that looked great for shooting, you know. Mm-hmm. She said, so I got my crew and I've got it, but I don't have anything for them to wear. What do you know?
Wow. Open door.
I happen to have things. So she's going to be doing a fashion cover with this beautiful model.
Oh, my God. That's great.
One of the dresses that I showed her is this one. It's sort of a Persian red.
Yeah, it's
very
gorgeous.
Very outstanding.
It's kind of hard to see, but it is beaded up here, and it's got a nice sexy slit up one side,
uh-huh,
which is what I'm talking about. And then we were saying how contemporary this looks, but how old would you say? What?
Oh, it's probably about 70s.
1970s. And it looks like it could be on the red carpet today.
Well,
I mean,
well,
it's gorgeous.
As I was saying before, after the 40s, evening gowns all pretty much look alike. You can't really put a year to them.
Yeah.
It's very difficult.
It is difficult.
Although this one, this dress I wore in my nightclub back in Tokyo, it's a little light. I don't know if you'd be able to see that or
not. Did you both catch that? Her nightclub act in Tokyo. Tokyo. That's like in a different country, right?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to talk about this. It is hard to see. It is hard to see. But we'll talk about this. We have a commercial already.
Okay.
So we're going to break for commercials, come right back, and we're going to talk more about Carol's dresses, which are fabulous.
Hi, I'm Greg Rood, a local real estate agent working with London Properties. You might be thinking about buying or selling a property right now, or maybe you just have a question about real estate. I'd love to help you with that. Give me a call at 352-7716, and I can answer any questions that you might have. Maybe you've got a property that's upside down. Maybe you're interested in buying a bank foreclosure and have a question about that. Or maybe you just like someone to show you some houses that you're interested in or have a question about a particular property. Once again, give me a call. My name's Greg, 352-7716, and I'd love to help you. Thanks.
This just in. Tower District houses are selling for as little as $300 per month. If you have a job and decent credit, you can own your own home. If you can come up with a down payment, you can own a home a lot cheaper than you can rent, and your payment will never go up. Also, you could deduct most of your house payment from your income taxes. If you'd like to lock in your monthly house payment at $300 to $500 per month for the next 30 years, call Mike Briggs Properties, 486-6758. Mike Briggs Properties, 486-6758.
Hi, I'm Jason Gobelli, and I'd like you to take just a minute and ask yourself a couple of questions. Are your needs being met in the real estate business? Are you getting all the latest technology that you need to be productive in this market? Are you getting the benefits that you deserve? Do you have enough leads? Are you truly making enough money for all that hard work and time you've been putting in? If not, you might want to give me a call and we can set up a confidential interview. At Connect Realty, we're one of the fastest growing companies around. There's tons of tools and benefits for agents, like free realtor.com showcase listings, free unlimited virtual tours, free websites with nationwide IDX. We have free virtual back office, free compliance coordinator so that you can be paid right away. There's health insurance, life insurance, and the best part is the commissions start from 80% and go to 95%. And we have one of the best retirement plans in the whole industry. Now, I cannot possibly go over everything in this just this short minute. Go to the website, careers@connectrealty.com, or feel free to call us at the toll-free number, or you can even call my personal line, 559-307-0550. I look forward to talking to you. Thanks.
This segment is brought to you by Corrine Hatfield of Platinum Mortgage. If you are thinking of purchasing a new home or refinancing an existing home, call Corrine Hatfield at 917-7111.
CentralValleyTalk.com.
Welcome back. We are with Carol Love. And we were talking about her dresses, and before we went to the break, we were talking about this. Too bad we can't see it. This is a gorgeous green strapless, very diaphanous kind of gown. So tell us the story behind this.
Well, I bought it. I was working in cabaret at the time, and I got the chance to go to Japan and do the nightclub act. So I was in Chicago at the time, and I bought this dress, and this was in the 60s. So this has been around a while, but this is how I looked at that time in the dress. I don't know if you can see that or not.
And notice the hairstyle is very similar to what it was then.
Can you see that
gorgeous.
Okay?
Okay. Unfortunately, it's hard to pan in, but I think we can get the gist of it. I wish it was a little bit darker,
yeah.
But it's absolutely gorgeous. And this is going to be one of the dresses for sale?
Yes, that's already in the shop.
Oh, my God. Okay, dare I ask how much it will go for?
I have no idea. She repriced everything.
Oh, she did.
I was giving things away for nothing.
Well, yes, I remember this from last
time.
I just wanted to show this real quick. I'm so impressed with this. I have to read this. This is Carol's autobiography, which leads me to my next question really quickly. I would love Carol to just give a very brief background, because this girl's been on Broadway. You have worked with phenomenal actors and actresses. So give us a little background before we show some of your collection.
Oh, okay. Well, I got started professionally. I had a girlfriend that was in the movie of Porgy and Bess with Pearl Bailey. And she was my roommate, and she was going on tour with Pearl. And I said, well, you know, if somebody drops out or something, let me know. And she says, oh, would you like to go? And I said, are you kidding? I was in the show.
Easy as that.
So I toured the U.S. and Canada with Pearl Bailey, and then I got out of the show and stayed in New York. And I was in New York for 8 years. I did a lot of off-Broadway things and summer stock and things like that. So, and then when I came back, I got into the first Broadway show of... the first one was Funny Girl. The second one was Cabaret. And that brought me back to California again. So, and I just always kept myself busy in the theater somehow. Even if I couldn't get a job, I would write a play and produce it.
Yeah,
anything to stay in. But I met a lot of really interesting people, and it's all in the autobiography. And what is important to me is that now I named it Autobiography of a Failure, which sounds From Hell to Heaven, which sounds bad, but actually, you know, you don't have to be a star to write your autobiography. And my life was really different than most people. I didn't get married till I was 65. So that's a lot of different things. It's really different. And it's got a lot of things about different people I met. I worked for Carol Channing and all sorts of interesting
things. Tons of pictures. How would somebody get one of these?
They just go on my website, which is carollovescreations.com.
Well, I do want to read
it.
I'm going to order one.
Okay,
I want to read it.
Okay.
I think it's going to be... Of course, I want an autograph.
Learn about my wicked, wicked life.
Yes. better than... Yes. All right. So, do you want to show some of the things that you brought?
Yes, let's show a few things that I brought.
Do you want to sit, or do you want to stand and show them?
I'll
and then kind
stand.
Of... Okay.
This little oriental is for a little girl, and I just think it is so absolutely gorgeous.
It is beautiful, and it's beaded, and it's slit on the side. Very, very oriental.
Yeah.
Like you said it.
And we got a lot of adult oriental stuff that's really gorgeous, too.
And the color, the camera, unfortunately, doesn't... It's a beautiful teal with gold. It's really beautiful. Now, did you make these? Did you...
No.
You collected them.
Now, this is a 40s evening gown.
Mm.
I don't know if you can see it or not, but it's just outstanding. This is vintage 40s. It's got
beautiful.
Only one shoulder, one sleeve, and then the shoulders open here.
Now, how contemporary is that? Wouldn't you just see that today?
Yeah, it's very hard to tell.
You know.
Some of the 40s and 30s you can obviously tell, but others you can't. This is a little oriental thing that you can slip over, just a little plain dress.
Ooh, I love that.
You know?
Or, I really like that. Let me stand up and get a little better
Over
look.
A gold dress or over a...
Or just like a black...
black?
Like a cat suit.
Yeah.
What am I trying to say? Like...
Even a little flax suit.
Yeah,
black.
Yeah, exactly. Like, oh, you know what? Okay, I'm just going to keep this. I'll talk to you about that after the show.
Another one of the...
Again, a beautiful teal with gold. This would be great.
But all of my stuff is, none of it's worn out old stuff.
No, this is beautiful. It's in beautiful condition. It is, it's not threadbare. It is just new. It just looks
new. And I mean, if you paid prices for it new, you're getting up to the thousands, some of this stuff.
I have no doubt.
And the last one is a little larger size top that you can wear with a black skirt or a red skirt or a green skirt or whatever you want to wear it with.
Beautiful.
Maybe formal.
Now, anyone who knows me loves, I love the sparkle. So, you know, if this were for me, you know, I'd take it in on the sides and just wear it with black, like stretch pants.
Yeah.
You know.
Okay, and then I did bring one pair of shoes. We're going to have shoes too. Really beautiful. I got a lot of period shoes too. But
now these are beautiful.
Really
now
pretty.
These look brand new. Have they ever been worn?
No, I don't think these have ever been worn. No.
What size are they?
6.
Oh well. What do you have? All sizes or just size 6?
Well, I have so many shoes and they're all different sizes.
Okay.
And we're also going to have hats when they put up some shelves in the vintage room over there. So we'll have hats and gloves and all sorts of things.
Now, go ahead and take a seat because we've got lots more to talk about. Put these over here. First of all, we film in the tower, right? We're on we're in the Tower District, and this particular we shrank. We need booster seats. I know we're getting old, but we're not shrinking that fast. Come on, give us a break. Where is this store? And maybe we can put the... Okay, here we go. It's up Carol's Clothing?
It's Freebird Company.
Freebird Company.
And it's on 838 East Olive. It's
Which
practically
is right
across
the street
from the studio
from
here.
From where we are right now.
And they have all sorts of interesting things in that store. I mean, up to date, but all with a little old feeling, you know.
Retro.
Retro.
Very
yeah.
retro. When you drive by, they have these beautiful, like, tie-dyed kind of bohemian kind of dresses, which I love because they're great just to, you know, wear comfortable, or, you know, just go out and just have some fun.
Right.
But then you've got, like, the 60s, 70s vibe out in front, and then you have, like, really retro. Your
Well,
thing
I don't think
back.
They want to go back as far as my retro. They're back to the 20s.
Well, I would. I think those are...
Let's sell some of this, and then we can put some more stuff in. But anyway, they fixed the room all up just for the vintage. And they, right at this point, they have a rope on it, so it's not open yet until probably about the 15th of the month. But sometimes she let one lady win it, desperate to get a wedding dress, and she bought this beautiful 30s style wedding dress.
A wedding dress?
And she looked absolutely, I've got a picture of her, she looked absolutely
you didn't bring
gorgeous.
That?
Well, I figured she might not want people to see
her
wedding dress before her wedding.
Oh,
so
I
that's
see.
That's the only
I
reason
see.
I didn't bring it.
I thought you had a picture of it.
But
just by itself.
Linda is very good about not, she doesn't, if you're going to go into that room, she goes with you. She's protecting everything.
Okay.
You know, she doesn't want to beat out a place. And so it's really sort of a very, very special inner sanctum. And people are like, please,
oh,
I want to get wait. When are you going to open it?
I can't wait. I think you should have champagne. I think you should do it up, you know, like a grand occasion.
To about it. Once we know the date for sure, we will.
Will you keep us posted on that? Because
definitely.
I'd love to announce and let everyone know because you
definitely
really
will.
Now, you, how many pieces total were in your collection or in your collection?
Well, probably as far as this type of thing, it would be probably about 1,000 pieces.
Okay, 1,000 pieces. Obviously, they're not all going to be there at the same time.
Oh, yeah.
So you're going to have, is it going to be by theme or by decade, or is it just going to be bits and pieces of everything all
I
at once?
I think she just, of course, they had quite a few of their own vintage. So they're there with mine. And they're just on racks, you know, just go look on the racks.
Any mannequins, anything that are going
to
be on
they're
display?
They're planning on that,
good.
But I'm not sure if they have them yet. They're working so hard on it. And,
I bet they
you know,
are.
They're trying to run two stores with two people, and that's a very hard thing to do.
Well, I would love to have them on with you. If
I will
you
talk
can
to them.
Talk to them and bring them on, and we can advertise all their stores.
Yeah.
And plus the new collection that they're going to be offering for you.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe by that time we'll be able to talk maybe some pricing, because I know that's kind of important these
yes,
days.
It
I mean,
is.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I know the prices that you were telling me when you were first on the show, and it was like, Carol, you're giving these dresses away. These are really works of art, some of them.
Still going to be a lot less than a lot of people charge.
But you were telling us last time you had put an ad in the Hollywood Reporter for this whole collection, and those ads don't run cheap.
That was $600.
$600 for an ad in Hollywood Reporter, and you got
like.
And
I told you about the Ukraine, right?
Yeah, you got a response from the Ukraine.
$276 to send the catalog over there because I was not yet on Facebook.
Thank God for Facebook. How would we communicate with anybody if it weren't for Facebook?
The most important thing is that since I was with you and got that started. I just started saying, I'm going to stop pushing. I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait on God and see what. And it's just so fabulous to see the things that he's doing. And my God, I wouldn't have been able to do that. How would I have met these people? How would I have met you? It's all as if, why did I even collect all those things?
Well,
it just got, and God is and so far ahead of you.
Isn't that the truth? God, we have to rely. We have to just let go and let God.
We have to learn to trust a little bit more.
This is my favorite saying, and let go and let God. And we're up at the break at the bottom of the hour. Time goes by so fast. But I do want to thank you so much, Carol. Carol Love has been our first guest. And her store is going to be opening up in the tower this month.
Yes.
Yes. Sometime this month. I'll keep you posted. I can't wait to see it. I think it should be a grand occasion. I really do. I think this warrants, breaking out the champagne and having an announcement and all that. But thank you so much for coming. It's so great seeing you again, and I'm so happy and thankful that God's taken the reins.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, anytime, Carol. You can come back anytime.
Okay, honey.
So you come back in a couple of minutes, and we have our next guest ready to come on.
Mike Briggs Properties has a very special historic property for sale that can be used as a home or as a business. This classic California Craftsman historical home is located in the Tower District, Fresno High area. The interior ambiance displays a heyday of Craftsman aesthetics, substance, strength, symmetry, and casual grace. Elegantly appointed mahogany and oak structural elements integrate form and function in a harmonious flow from room to room in this two-story, 4,500-foot home. The property also includes a nearly 800-foot, two-bedroom apartment above the garage. This property is well-suited for a professional office type of business or for a large family or combined living and workspace. The lot included with this property is park-sized, with plenty of room for expansion or as a parking lot big enough to support a commercial business. For more information on this property, call Mike Briggs Properties at 486-6758. Mike Briggs Properties, 486-6758.
Welcome to Jasmine's Porch.
How about that?
We have been doing this for a year.
My memory of the porch is that it's very much where women rule. It was almost a throne.
Going like that.
I'm circular. See, Southern folks are circular. What she said, preach. You want me to preach? Love sharing those things and those things that'll make you stronger and better and go forward.
I ain't gonna let nobody turn me around. Turn me around.
Hey.
Turn me around, ain't gonna let nobody.
Okay, no more drama.
To myself, I said,
myself
said, yeah.
Oh. That was a good one.
That was good, girl.
That was good.
You become the best reflection of yourself, and what was that? The one God intended all along. We're gonna get there together, I promise you.
Thank God for the post.
Amen.
You can advertise your business, your product, or your event on Central Valley Talk, the Valley's only internet television station. Several of our programs are also picked up on Dish and cable networks. For the best advertising dollar, call Central Valley Talk at 579-1360. This segment is brought to you by Blimpies in the Tower District. For all of your lunch and dinner needs, go to Blimpies in the Tower District.
CentralValleyTalk.com.
That Kylie told me a million times, Kathy, when you're on the right side of the screen, that means you're on. So I'm talking away, and she goes, no, you're not on yet. Anyway, that's my problem. So welcome back, and we have our next guest ready to roll, and this is the lovely Dora Duarte.
Thank you.
And she is here from Sherman Bros Trucking. Now, welcome to our number one, to Voice of the Valley, and thank you for coming all the way. Now, where do you live?
I live in Riverdale.
Riverdale, which is kind of a hike. Kind of a hike. How long did it take you to get here?
It's about 40 minutes.
Hey, 40 minutes. Uh-huh. Well, thank you so much for coming.
We're really
happy to have you here. Okay. I'm the first to admit, I know virtually nothing about trucking. And, I mean, you're so beautiful. I don't even know how did you get into trucking? And then we'll get into what she does and all of that, but...
How I got into trucking,
Not that you're a trucker.
No,
she's not a trucker.
Although I had a commercial license for some time, but my husband and I started a business in the trucking industry, and I loved it. You know, there's so many different things that you can do, in trucking, and it's fascinating. You know, most people think that, oh, you just get on the truck and you drive and that's it. No, there's a lot of, you know, licensing and permits involved, and so, you know, there's a lot of different facets to the industry.
Well, I understood this after I got Dora's email with all these different specifics about trucking. So we're going to get right into it because I want to learn more about this.
Perfect.
Okay, so you're a California recruiter for Sherman Bros Trucking. Mm-hmm. Now, exactly what does that mean?
Let me mention a little bit about the company.
Sure, absolutely.
Yeah, I want to make sure that this is acknowledged. The Sherman Brothers started this company in 1969, and so, you know, they started working as a small company, and so they learned the business and they, you know, made it bigger. So in 1987, the son of Leroy, one of the founders, joined the corporation, and so, you know, that's how it got going. And so a family. It's a
family-owned business. Okay, great.
Uh-huh. And so how did I start working for Sherman Brothers? I
asked the questions, Dora. You don't have to ask your own questions. How did you get started working for Sherman Brothers?
Yep. Position listed on Craigslist, actually.
Okay.
And so I submitted my resume, and a couple of days later, I got a call from Chris Rice, who's now my supervisor.
Okay.
And so, you know, he told me, you know, what the job was about, and I was very interested since I, you know, thought I had a lot of experience in the trucking industry, so I was very interested.
Fantastic.
And
now, tell us, you have a phenomenal educational background. Tell us your degrees.
Yes, I have a political science degree from the University of Fresno.
Woohoo!
And then last year I graduated from the University of Phoenix with an MBA.
Isn't that fantastic?
So I'm very happy for that.
Congratulations, Mazel to you. That's a lot
Thank
of work.
You. It was.
And you have little children.
Yes, I have four children, and they're my life, so I love that.
Ranging from?
From 17 to 6.
Mm-hmm. That's a lot on a plate.
I just love to keep busy.
Obviously you do. So, okay, so now you have gotten the job, and they hired you as a recruiter.
Yes, a California recruiter.
And so is it something that you want to talk about and how people...
Yes. I thought about, you know, this show because I want to get the word out there on, you know, how to get a job in the trucking industry, especially, you know, with Sherman Brothers Trucking. I know there's a lot of unemployed drivers out there, and so I thought we need to get the word out there. You know, we're constantly hiring, and so, you know, we just want to get the word out there and get those people unemployed to come and join.
Isn't that fantastic? With the economy, I never even thought about how it would affect the trucking business, but gas, skyrocketing gas prices. So Sherman Brothers is hiring.
Yes.
Mazel to that. I mean, that's fantastic. Mm-hmm. And so tell us a little about what you're looking for, or, you know, just take us through what you would like to cover.
Sure. The company is a heavy equipment, you know, type of trucking company. And so the company pulls flatbeds, mainly glass, out of California.
Okay. Slow down. Uh-huh. Talk to the person who knows nothing. You said pull glass.
Transport glass.
Like big sheet
glass?
Yes,
big big sheets of
that would go in an office building or something?
Yes.
Got it. Okay.
So we transport those on flatbeds, okay. And you know, people who know the industry know, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, so well, that's not me. So that's why I've got to go real basic.
Yes, the company also has, you know, other fleets such as tanker fleet and you know, it's called bladder or well, it's mainly the tanker fleet.
Tanker being they carry liquid,
the tanks, yes.
The gasoline,
yes.
Or okay,
uh-huh.
Okay.
So
it's not just one kind of thing that they haul. It's various things.
Various things.
Okay.
Yes. Uh-huh. Also heavy equipment. But out of California, we're concentrating on transporting glass. We have a couple of major customers here in California. One is out of the Lathrop area, and the other one is in Kingsburg, California.
Where they manufacture glass?
Yes. They actually make the glass. It's amazing.
Who knew?
I didn't know that. Right. I had the opportunity to go to the plant, and I went to the back, you know, where they store this big pieces of glass. I mean,
wow.
They're huge, and, you know, it's like, wow. You know, this is done here in the Central Valley. It's like,
how
wow.
Do they store glass?
The warehouse is very, very big.
Yeah.
So they handle everything by a crane.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, with a crane, they load and unload.
Very gently.
Yes.
Can you imagine?
Very dangerous, you know.
Mm-hmm. Is it safety glass or is it?
It's different type of glass.
A different type
yeah,
of glass.
Yeah, tempered
okay.
glass and, you know.
Okay.
Just, as long as it's glass, you know, it's
that could be
kind.
A whole show by itself.
Yes.
Glass industry.
Yes.
And, didn't even,
uh-huh.
Who knew?
Yes.
Anyway.
I was amazed when
yeah.
I visited the plant.
I bet.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Yes.
That's great. And we have it right here in Fresno, in the
yes.
in the valley.
Here in Kingsburg, California.
Yeah, Kingsburg. Mm-hmm. So you're located in, out of, Sherman Brothers is located out of Oregon.
Yes.
Okay,
uh-huh.
So that's where the headquarters is.
That is correct.
Now, are they only hiring for California?
No. We're
okay.
actually hiring nationwide.
Now, is that you, or are you just covering California?
I'm just covering California.
Okay,
yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you have a California fleet,
mm-hmm.
and what are, we want to make it really clear, this is, Dora is looking for people to
mm-hmm.
hire. Okay, so she's a job connection right here, and I don't have to tell anybody that the economy still sucks, and lots of people are still looking for work.
A lot of drivers. I log into the Cal Jobs website mm-hmm. on a daily basis. I see like 50 resumes on there.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, a lot of people are unemployed.
Can we flash on the screen now how to get in touch with you, and then at
sure.
the end, the website, did you send in a...
Yes. The website for the hiring section is www.drive4, and that's number 4, sbi.com, and that's the direct hiring site.
So they can send resumes
yes.
to your attention, Dora Duarte.
Actually, they can send the resume to my email, which
okay.
is Dora D at... And I think I listed it here. It's Dora D at sbht.com.
When we put it up on the screen, then everybody can see it, and then
perfect.
They can write it down.
Okay.
Okay.
However, the process, you know, the way we do it, they have to log into our website and submit the application.
Okay.
You know, with the technology now, everything is done electronically.
Everything.
Yes. So we have an amazing database that, you know, we, once the driver enters the application, we get it right away on our database, and we review the application,
mm-hmm.
and that's what I do on a daily basis. I review hundreds of applications.
Wow.
Once I see that, you know, the applicant is, you know, qualified, it's not qualified, but I see that, you know, we can do something with
mm-hmm.
that application, I pass it on to the background investigators up
okay.
in Harrisburg, Oregon, who check the background and also the employment history.
Mm-hmm.
So that is very important. As per DOT, we have to check that. And we check the driving record, which
yeah.
it has to be not perfect, but, you know, a decent
I
driving record.
I would hope
record.
So for driving a truck, yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And so then the employment history. We don't want to find out that a driver was dismissed from a previous employer because they failed a drug test.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's a major.
Major.
So once we get that, it's an automatic, you know, disqualification.
Now, what about, Dora, what about a driving record? What would immediately, what's your limit? I mean, as far as speeding or traffic violations, or what is a definite no? As soon as you see that there's no chance.
Right. If there is a lot of activity on their driver, you know, record, then it's a automatic disqualification. But they're allowed to have like 3 points within the last 5 years.
Okay, 3 points.
Which means that they had maybe a speeding ticket or a stop sign. You know, they run a stop sign or minor things.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing that we're really checking on is the criminal background. No felonies or misdemeanors in the last 10 years.
Jesus.
Sometimes if it's more than 10 years, you know, they have a chance of qualifying. However, if they have a crime of a violent nature, then that's a total no. It's a, you know, automatic disqualification.
Okay.
No crimes of, you know, violent nature.
So they've ever been on Cops, the show?
Right, yes.
They're not tired.
Uh-huh.
I'm just joking. Yes. I have no idea. Uh-huh. But we are up for commercial. It was a little getting a little heavy there with felonies and violent things, so yes. I thought I'd lighten the atmosphere a little bit. We have a commercial. We're going to come back with Dora, and if you have any questions for Dora, this would be a great time to ask. There is, if you're watching on your computer, to the right of your screen, it says CBT host. You can type in a question in real time, and Dora can answer that right away, but we'll be back in a couple of minutes. Thanks.
America's Sub Shop has arrived in the Tower District. Blimpie's is the best place to get delicious sandwiches, salads, baked goods, and smoothies at reasonable prices. You won't believe the great value of Blimpie's $5 combo deals. The fresh baked bread and big bowl tastes will bring you in, and the friendly service and great prices will keep you coming back. A Blimpie sandwich is great on your lunch break or as a healthy meal for the whole family. Try Blimpie's today, located directly across from the Tower Theater. We know you'll love it.
Welcome to Voice of the Valley. I am your host, Cathy Wilcox. And two of Kathy's favorite things are going to be featured on the show today. Number one is money. Number two, alcohol! My first guest. I have to get up. I have to show you this dress because I think it was made for me. I want to die. Doesn't this just scream Marilyn? I'm
dressed
like this is great. Audi, as you can see,
right here. Number one selling wine from
Argentina.
Cathy Wilcox, Voice of the Valley. Wednesdays at 2 on Channel 43.
Hi, Bill Carmichael here, manager of Valley Gold Mine Fresno. I'd like to tell everybody that we've relocated to the Tower District at 1212 North Van Ness Avenue. If you have any broken or unwanted jewelry you'd like to get top dollar for, give us a call at 559-970-8660. Also, we're on the web at www.valleygoldminefresno.com. If you're the type that likes to entertain at home, we have some gold parties that we can tell you about. And also, if you have children in schools and they have trouble raising funds, we have a great fundraiser that works as well. Once again, my number is 559-970-8660. Thank you.
This segment is brought to you by David Parker from the law offices of Parker, Kern, Nard, and Wenzel.
CentralValleyTalk.com.
With Sherman Brothers Trucking, and we're going to go over some things because there's lots of information to get through. So what is the process for people who would like to be a driver for your company?
Right. Okay. That's the most important thing.
Okay. Let's get to that.
For people that are interested to understand what is the
process. Okay.
Okay. So, some people call me, and so I speak with them on the phone. I do a preliminary interview to see if they're, you know, qualified candidates. So I'm able to, pretty much pre-qualify, you know.
Okay.
So once I speak with the drivers or the applicants, they have to log into our website, like we mentioned. They enter their application. And so from there, after I get it, I review it. And, you know, if I see that, you know, they're look good, you know, the application looks pretty good, I pass it on to the background investigators, which check on the employment history and criminal background and, you know, driving record and, you know, all of that. So once the background investigators get all that information in the system, then they turn it, turn them over to the manager, mm-hmm. which is my manager, Chris Rice. I want to mention his name.
Hi, Chris.
He's a wonderful person to work with. And so then he is part of the hiring committee. So human resources and Chris and then one of the other administrators, you know, decide, look at all the components of this application, and they're the ones who decide if this applicant qualifies for the job.
And then is there a face-to-face interview at some point with your manager?
Not necessarily.
No?
Okay. No. We do everything online, which
really?
Is wonderful. I love it.
Wow.
Once in a while, I meet with the driver.
Uh-huh.
If they have, you know, problems logging into the Internet or they don't have access to Internet, once I conduct the preliminary interview and I see that this individual is qualified, then I schedule an appointment to meet with them.
Okay.
Okay. So after the hiring committee agrees on hiring an applicant, then we make arrangements to send these applicants to orientation.
Mm-hmm.
The orientation goes for a whole week.
Okay.
And
where does that take place? So
that
physically,
takes
where
place,
is
uh-huh,
where
in
is that?
Harrisburg, Oregon.
Oh, okay.
At our
okay.
headquarters.
So do you fly them up?
We make arrangements. Sometimes we fly them up there, or we make arrangements with Amtrak or Greyhound,
okay.
depending on the
okay.
preference.
Good.
And so at the orientation, they go through all the physical, they fill out the paperwork that is needed to hire a person.
Mm-hmm.
They also go through the driving test and, the learning or getting more experience on how to secure the loads. So it's very
okay.
physical, very
okay.
hands-on what we do at the orientation. And so after the orientation is done, they also do the physical exam,
mm-hmm.
the drug and alcohol testing.
Mm-hmm.
That is a major, major thing in the transportation industry. And so after that is done, at the end of the orientation, the trainers decide if they're ready to jump in their own vehicle, in their own truck, or they are going to send the trainees with a senior truck driver for additional training.
I see.
Mm-hmm.
Do people have to have their own trucks, or do you supply?
They don't have to have their own trucks, but if they do, it's what's called owner operators.
Okay.
And we also hire owner operators.
Okay.
If they have their own truck and they're interested in working, driving for Sherman Brothers.
Okay.
We do hire them.
Perfect. We have a question.
Let's sure.
see. Are these long hauls or local driving jobs?
That's a very good question because
great question.
Probably 80% of the people that I speak with on a daily basis, they want to stay local.
Okay.
And we do what's called regional driving. It's not over the road. Over the road is more like 48 states, but this is more regional, which means we go to Oregon, Washington, Nevada, Arizona, Idaho, and Utah.
Okay. So that's still kind of a... To me, that's a long haul, but for a truck driver, that's probably
yes.
not as extensive as like going across country.
That is correct.
Yeah.
It's
okay.
not as long. They don't get to spend, a whole month out of their homes. They come, home like every 7 to 10 days.
Okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And you mentioned the regional, California, Oregon, Washington, Arizona,
yes.
Nevada, Utah, and Idaho. Okay. And then you wrote in here, which I thought was really interesting, about the rate of pay. And again, I know nothing about... truck driving. So it was like 34 cents. Oh my God, how can you make a living on that? But I mean, you're really racking up the miles here, right?
That's right.
Okay.
Drivers, they run thousands of miles.
Yeah.
So if you multiply 0.34 times 5,000,
so
then
I'd be driving like 5 miles and go, okay, 34 times 5. I just made that.
Yeah, that's right. No, these drivers go thousands of miles.
So that's typical. I mean, everybody
yes.
who's a truck driver would
yes.
know that that's,
uh-huh.
A fair rate of pay.
That's
and it,
right.
And
yes.
so you pay 34
uh-huh.
to 39
very
cents.
Very competitive.
It's
yes.
very, okay, very competitive pricing. Good to know.
Right.
Benefits?
Yes.
Great.
Uh-huh. The company offers benefits. And with that, I mean health insurance, dental, and vision. and that is good after the first 30 days of employment. Most companies wait 90 days or, you know.
A lot of companies do wait 90 days, yeah.
So with our company, is after the first 30 days of employment, they qualify for this benefit.
Fantastic.
Mm-hmm. And then also vacation after the first year of employment.
That's fair.
They qualify for vacation.
That's fair, mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's 5 days?
It's about a week
a
to
week?
Start.
Mm-hmm. And now is that paid or is that?
That's paid vacation.
It's paid vacation.
Yes.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. And, okay, so you mentioned home time, I guess, mm-hmm. That's probably a very important aspect of the truck driving industry.
It is very important. That's one of the first questions I get from my applicants, how often I'm going to be back at home.
Okay, and then how do you answer
Depending
that?
Depending on the area, if it's Central Valley or actually for the California area, drivers get to go home every 7 to 10 days.
Wow, 7 to 10 days.
And, yeah, they stay 1 to 2 days, you know. Rest time, and then if they need more time at home, then they'll need to make arrangements with their fleet managers.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Dora, we have a couple of minutes left.
Sure.
What else that's really important do you want to get to so that we can get the information out there and hopefully get people at work?
Right.
That would
right.
be fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
What else on here do you want to get to?
I want to talk about the it's so important for drivers to keep a clean record. You know, some people think that, well, you know, I'm a truck driver, you know, that's what counts. No, they need to have a clean record, driving record. They also need to have current experience. They need to have recent and current driving experience in order to be qualified. Some drivers work in the trucking industry for several years, and then they take like a 2-year break. And then they want to rejoin.
And that's not good.
It's not good because if they want to get with a stable company like Sherman Brothers Trucking, they need to have recent driving experience.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And
anything else on here that's just super important? We want to put your we've got your all the information up on the screen.
Yes. Uh-huh.
And
maybe my phone number.
A phone number?
Helpful. Yes. Uh-huh.
Do you want to say your phone number?
Yes, my number for everybody that's interested. You can call me. Anytime from 7 in the morning to 7 at night.
Oh, my Lord. Dora, the hours. We have to talk about your hours.
My number is 559-554-4174. Or email me. But after we talk on the phone, I'm going to recommend you to go online and submit your application online.
So if you're a truck driver and you're looking for a job and you meet these qualifications, call this woman. I mean,
yes,
she's like, excellent, outstanding. Dora, thanks. We're going to wrap things up. Thank you so much for coming and talking about Sherman Brothers Trucking.
Thank you very
trucking.
Much, everybody, and I really hope to get, you know, some people out there or some people to go back to work because, you know, the unemployment rate is really, really
and please let me know because I'd like to tell my viewers, like, yeah, we got some jobs out there for some truck drivers. That would be fantastic.
Okay.
Thank you,
perfect.
Dora.
Thank you, Cathy.
All
thank
right.
You very
thanks
much.
For coming in. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.
Hi. I'm Greg Rude, a local real estate agent, working with London Properties.
Excellent job.
You might be thinking about buying or selling a property right now, or maybe you just have a question about real estate. I'd love to help you with that. Give me a call at 352-7716, and I can answer any questions that you might have. Maybe you've got a property that's upside down. Maybe you're interested in buying a bank foreclosure and have a question about that. Or maybe you just like someone to show you some houses that you're interested in or have a question about a particular property. Once again, give me a call. My name is Greg, 352-7716, and I'd love to help you. Thanks.
This just in. Tower District houses are selling for as little as $300 per month. If you have a job and decent credit, you can own your own home. If you can come up with a down payment, you can own a home a lot cheaper than you can rent, and your payment will never go up. Also, you could deduct most of your house payment from your income taxes. If you'd like to lock in your monthly house payment at $300 to $500 per month for the next 30 years, call Mike Briggs Properties, 486-6758. Mike Briggs Properties, 486-6758.
Hi, I'm Jason Gobelli, and I'd like you to take just a minute and ask yourself a couple of questions. Are your needs being met in the real estate business? Are you getting all the latest technology that you need to be productive in this market? Are you getting the benefits that you deserve? Do you have enough leads? Are you truly making enough money for all that hard work and time you've been putting in? If not, you might want to give me a call and we can set up a confidential interview. At Connect Realty, we're one of the fastest growing companies around. there's tons of tools and benefits for agents, like free realtor.com showcase listings, free unlimited virtual tours, free websites with nationwide IDX. We have free virtual back office, free compliance coordinator so that you can be paid right away. There's health insurance, life insurance, and the best part is the commissions start from 80% and go to 95%. And we have one of the best retirement plans in the whole industry. Now, I cannot possibly go over everything in this just this short minute. Go to the website, careers@connectrealty.com, or feel free to call us at the toll-free number, or you can even call my personal line, 559-307-0550. I look forward to talking to you. Thanks.
This segment is brought to you by Corrine Hatfield of Platinum Mortgage. If you are thinking of purchasing a new home or refinancing an existing home, call Corrine Hatfield at 917-7111.
CentralValleyTalk.com.